Hey everyone, my name is Brian, and in this tutorial we're going to add a resizable sidebar to an existing Angular app. And we're going to do it using just the Angular CDK. No random libraries or weird hacks. If you've ever wanted to create a sidebar like the ones you see in VS Code or design tools, where you can click and drag to resize the panel, that's exactly what we'll be building. And we'll also add a reset button at the end, so users can jump back to the original layout at any time. Let's jump in. Now, before we get into the code, I do want to mention that the features you'll see in this example depend on the Angular CDK, specifically the drag and drop module. So if you're following along in your own project, you'll want to run this command to install the Angular CDK. I've already installed it in this demo project, but make sure it's installed in your own app before continuing. All right, here's where we're starting. A basic layout with a main column on the right and a sidebar on the left. Now, it might be a little difficult to tell which column is which right now, but we'll fix that soon. Also, there's a visual resizer bar between the two columns, but it doesn't actually do anything yet. Let's change that. For this example, I've already created a sidebar resize component that holds the basic layout we're seeing here. This is where we'll add the logic to make the sidebar resizable. So let's open up the component code and take a look at what we're starting with. You can see there's no drag logic yet. There's actually no logic at all. It's just a plain shell of a component. So we'll build this up step by step. Next, let's take a quick look at the template. We've got a main element that holds the main column content. It uses content projection to find an element with the slot main attribute and project that content into this region. We also have an aside element for the sidebar content, which also uses content projection with the slot sidebar attribute. Inside the sidebar, we've got a div with a resizer class. This is the visual edge between the two columns, and it's what we'll make draggable. Now, let's pop open the main AppRoot component so we can see how the component gets used. Here, in the template for this component, we're using the sidebar resize component. Here's our main content wrapped in a div with the slot main attribute. And then, here's the sidebar content in the div with the slot sidebar attribute. So, that's the basic setup. Now, let's make it resizable. Let's jump back to the sidebar resize component TypeScript and start building this out. First up, we'll add a default width property. This will be the initial width of our sidebar and also the value we reset to later. Next, let's create a signal to hold the current width and we'll initialize it to the default value. This will let us reactively bind the sidebar's width in the template and update it when the user drags the resizer. Now let's add the logic that will be triggered by the Angular CDK drag directive to actually resize the columns. We'll call it onDragMoved. And it'll take a parameter named event, which will be typed to a CDK drag move event. When this function is called, we'll respond to the drag event from the CDK and use the pointer's X position to update the sidebar width. Here, pointer position X gives us the horizontal cursor position on the page, which we can simply treat as the new width of the sidebar. But we also need to fix a small quirk when using the CDK drag directive for resizing like this. The directive applies a transform translate 3D style to the dragged element, and if we don't remove it, the resizer can visually drift away from the edge of the sidebar. So right after setting the width, we'll get the dragged element from the event, and then we'll reset the transform style. This will keep the handle visually pinned to the edge of the sidebar. At this point, we're finally ready to use the Angular CDK's drag directive in our template. But before we do that, we need to import the drag-drop module. So let's add it to the components imports array. Cool, now we can hook up the HTML. First, let's find the resizer div and add the CDK drag directive. This directive gives us a low overhead way to track pointer movement across mouse and touch devices. On this directive, there are a few different events available, but the one we need here is cdkDragMoved. This event fires every time the user drags, which can be a lot, so be careful using it in high-cost operations. But for this use case, it's exactly what we want. Now, when this event fires, it will fire with a cdkDragMoved event, so we can simply call our onDragMove method and pass it the event. Now, for the last step, on the aside element, I'll use style binding to bind the width to the current width signal. So now, whenever the signal changes, the width style will update automatically. Okay, this thing should be resizable at this point. Let's save everything and check it out in the browser. Nice! At first glance, it still looks similar, but now, when I click and drag the handle, the sidebar resizes in real time. Pretty cool, right? It's smooth, it's responsive, and we didn't need any third-party libraries or anything complicated. But what I'd like to do now is let users reset the layout to the original column widths. Let's take this one step further and add a reset button. Let's switch back over to the TypeScript. Here, let's add a new reset method. When this method is called, all we need to do is set the current width signal back to the default width. Now let's jump back to the template. Here, let's add a button element with a reset label. Then we'll use a click event binding to call our reset method when the button is clicked. Okay, that should be everything we need. Let's save again and give it a shot. Cool, now we have this reset button here. Now I'll resize the sidebar, and then I'll click reset. Boom, it snaps back just like it should. And that's it. We just built a clean, fully functional resizable sidebar using Angular CDK's drag-drop module, a couple of signals, and some simple width logic. If you found this helpful, feel free to like and subscribe for more Angular tips like this. And if you want to take it further, you could easily extend this to support vertical resizing, or even persist the sidebar width using local storage. Who knows, I might make a follow-up video showing exactly that. Anyways, thanks so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.